How's everybody doing? Good. Everybody well fed? Had a little lunch? Ready for the afternoon? Well, my name is Lauren. I'm one of the many people here today from Five Rivers Metro Park. Well, of course I love my job. But what I do and focus on at Metro Parks is working with school educators in our community. And so I want to tell you a little bit about what I do and then also introduce you to three outstanding educators that we have in presence right here that are doing amazing things right here in Montgomery County. So when it comes to Five Rivers Metro Parks and schools, we try and interact with schools in a lot of different ways. And you may be wondering, well, you know, why? But schools, if you think about our programs that we do out in our parks, on a Saturday like today, where it's nice and beautiful, those are families that are already somewhat interested in coming outdoors. There's some type of a spark already there. But schools gives us an opportunity to reach those students whose parents don't have that spark yet, and maybe when it comes to a sunny day on a Saturday, they're not necessarily thinking, let's go out to a park, or let's go get in the creek, or let's go catch a butterfly. Schools gives us an opportunity to reach those students in another way that maybe wouldn't make it out. And so we try and do that in a number of different ways. So we try and reach not just the students, but also the parents and the teachers. And so we have, of course, we have field trips, we do outreach opportunities where actually Doug and his staff come to classrooms and bring live animals and different things there. With parents, we try and get them involved through field trips and also through summits just like today. Do we have any parents here? But then also through teachers, and we do different workshops and training opportunities. Of course, providing field trips. But one really special thing that I want to share with you is our Outstanding Teacher Award. And the reason that we have this award is because not all educators in our area are taking that extra effort, because it does take extra time and extra effort to get these kids outside, but the rewards are just phenomenal. I know there's different quotes behind me from different teachers and different students for how much that they really enjoy and value getting outside and having the opportunity. Sometimes access and opportunity is the hardest part, and that's what they're lacking. And there are three teachers in particular that we recognize each year through our Outstanding Teacher Award. So this recognizes teachers that are going above and beyond and doing those things. We have three different categories for the award. So we have our Rising Star with 10 years or less in formal education. We have our Leader Award with 10 to 20 years in formal education. And then our Lifetime Achievement Award with 20 plus years in formal education. And these awardees, each year, we're super lucky. I feel really lucky. I get to read all the nominations, and then our panel of judges score them. But just hearing all the amazing things going on in our community. So if we could just pause for a moment and give a round of applause to all of our educators. But so the award winners, not only do they receive the recognition and the support then for the amazing things that they're doing, but they receive a field trip out to Cox Arboretum, membership to the Cox Arboretum Foundation, membership to the Environmental Education Council of Ohio. They also receive a plant kit so that they can start a green schoolyard at their school if they don't already have one, or enhance it if they already do, as well as outdoor education supplies, because those are a little bit different than your typical school supplies. And a lot of times, if your school wanted to have a set of binoculars for students or a set of field guides for students, those teachers might be trying to use their own money for that. So we want to try and support them in that way. So without further ado, I would love to introduce you to our first, so this slide right here, these are some of the examples of last year's award winners and some of the things that they purchased by way of outdoor education supplies, so a spotting scope, not typically in a normal school budget. And then for plants, you know, starting those raised beds. So just some examples of what teachers have done in the past. But our first award winner is our Rising Star. Oh, I'll get to that in a second. So the I'm just so excited to introduce you to her. But we do have we're in our fourth year with our Outstanding Teacher Award. So the 9 teachers that are behind me are our previous award winners. Some of you are in the audience, so thank you again and congratulations. With that, I will now introduce you to our first award winner for this year, Sarah Lamont. So Sarah is a preschool teacher at Learning Tree Farm Preschool. For those of you, you may be familiar with Learning Tree Farm. They actually now have a nature-based preschool, which is the first of its kind for the Dayton community. They're popping up all across the U.S., but for Dayton, this is the first of its kind. And for Sarah, nature is the medium for all things that she teaches, whether it's math, whether it's reading, art, literature, in her nature-based preschool. Her students spend 75% of their time learning outdoors, no matter the time of year, no matter the weather, making connections to all those content areas. I love the story in her denomination letter about learning the letter V by watching turkey vultures soaring and talking about letters that way. Or learning about life cycles through the plants and animals. Learning Tree Farm is super fortunate. So they have the farm right there and can see those farm animals growing and developing, as well as in their outdoor space in the forests and the prairies. And she's been instrumental in improving that space as well, bringing plants from her own home in to add to the space, working with grant writers and getting plants from Monarch Watch, creating a Monarch way station so you can certify your habitat, and she was very instrumental in that. She also spearheaded the effort for the Best in Ohio Connect to Nature Award, which I know that Cinda and Doug have been presenting a lot of those awards in the area, and Sarah spearheaded that effort for the nature-based preschool at Learning Tree Farm. And she spends her time, her free time, so not during the school time, but after school, meeting with families, going strawberry picking and blueberry picking, which I think is just phenomenal, and leading summer adventures, so that way the entire family gets involved, and that time in the summer, there's no disconnect there. And to top it all off, she was also instrumental in bringing this nature-based preschool to our area in Dayton. And so for all of those reasons and more, I am so excited to award you our Rising Star Outstanding Teacher. Teacher Award winner is in our leader category. Her name is Darcy Rodman. She's a kindergarten teacher at St. Charles Elementary. And so Darcy's kindergarten classroom is full of wonder, excitement, and inquiry as she engages her students in their natural environment. She weaves nature into the curriculum all year round. Well, in both of her classrooms. She sort of has an indoor classroom that has terrariums and crabs and fish tanks. And then she has her outdoor classroom with a butterfly garden and soon to be much, much more. Or actually currently much, much more, but it's still building. So she sort of has two classrooms going on there. And her students are constantly out in the outdoor classroom and immersed in nature. A lot of times her students are doing some of those typical things like reading and journaling outdoors. They're not doing that inside behind a desk. They're outside doing that throughout all times in the year. And Darcy also brings her students on many field trips. That's actually how I met Darcy for the first time. And her classes twice, one are no waste lunch. So at Casa Rhythm, we have the kids separate out. They're recycling their landfill waste and their compost. And her class won 2 years in a row. and received awards in for that. But to make sure that her kids have that outdoor space all year round and they don't have to always go on a field trip to get that, she created a butterfly garden. And that butterfly garden soon started to grow and is now part of the garden project. So she led this collaborative effort between parents, students, teachers, master gardeners, and the larger community that started getting on board when they saw all the cool stuff going into the space. She certified it as a Monarch Way Station, and many teachers around the school are starting to use that space themselves. Many at St. Charles would certainly attest that you have been the catalyst for this complete transformation of this outdoor classroom, and for sparking the love of learning and the love of nature in all students at St. Charles with your excellent work. So, Darcy, thank you so much for us. Therapist at Kaiser Elementary, one of our Dayton public schools. And for 21 years, Kathy Gooch has served Dayton public schools, working with students of all ages, preschool through high school, and she's currently making waves at Kaiser. After attending, actually, this summit back in 2014, summit in 2014, it inspired her to create an outdoor space for the students at Kaiser, because it's a very urban environment there, and a lot of those students don't have access to nature. And so she wanted to take that vision and make it a reality, and that's exactly what she's done. The students have been involved in every aspect of the space, from the planning, the planting, the weeding, the constant care that a garden takes up. There are many, many parts to this garden. So there's a vegetable area, and the students get to help with harvesting the vegetables there. There's a wildflower area and the native wildflower garden. There's herbs, there's sensory areas, as well as an outdoor classroom space. And one amazing thing too is that, of course, it's not just Kathy that's using it, it's the entire school. So there are these pictures, I'm finally remembering this. These pictures just go to show how involved the whole school is in this process. Sarni, her classroom is right over here. That was she nominated Kathy for this award. They put in three peace poles. You can see one of them right down here. For all the work that the different members of the community have taken as far as creating this space. And Kathy spearheaded this whole thing. Their principal is right up there with the kids too. So it's totally transformed how the space is used for the entire school. The garden has also become an important environment for the students with motor disabilities, and it's accessible to all students in that way, and it's really important for a lot of those developmental milestones that they're working towards. And they also started the Garden Lunch Bunch. So these students, they want to get out there all the time. So a couple of them at a time each day get to go on out during lunchtime. And they get to spend their lunches out in this really cool environment too. So It's just neat to see how much it's become part of the school community. And for that and everything that you do, Kathy, congratulations. So if you're wondering, if you're seeing this and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I know a teacher that deserves an award like this, they're doing amazing things, we'll start accepting nominations in October if you go to www.metroparks.org/outstanding. So just remember, outstanding. You can nominate your a teacher that you know. We'll be accepting nominations again starting in October through January 31st. So keep that in mind for this coming year. But thank you again to all of our educators that are doing amazing things and for coming out today. And I think we'll probably try and get all three of our amazing award winners in the back for a big group picture. Thank you.